Hey guys, it's Miss Des again. Do you remember the first craft we made to go with our book, The Hungry, Hungry Caterpillar? The Very Hungry Caterpillar. Together, we made a very hungry caterpillar. What does the very hungry caterpillar turn into in the book? Do you remember?
I remember. He turns into a beautiful butterfly. So I bet you can guess what we're going to make next.
That's right. We're going to make a beautiful butterfly. Come do some art with me. In your kit, you should have gotten not only the supplies for the caterpillar, but a template that looks like this. Some pieces of tissue paper. And two pieces of contact paper that are about the same size as your template. I'm going to set those aside. And the glue stick, because I don't need that. The first thing we're going to do is cut out the outside of the butterfly. So all along the solid line. Don't worry about the dotted line or the shaded in areas quite yet. Oops, I almost dropped it. I'm gonna do the antennas last, because those are tricky. Once you cut around the outside, it'll look something like this. Now I'm going to carefully cut out the little antennas. Last time, I accidentally cut them off. But that still works, because then you can just lay them on the contact paper. It's okay to get some help if you need help. almost. There we go. The next thing we have to do is cut out the inside shaded area. The easiest way to do that is to make a little fold and put a cut in the middle and open it back up. Now you have a hole to put your scissors into. Put your scissors into the hole and cut just to the dotted line. Now follow that dotted line all the way around. This piece will come out and you'll be left with this. Now do the same thing on the other side. A little fold, a little cut so you can put your scissors in there. Stick your scissors in and go just to the dotted line. Follow it around again. If you make a mistake, it is very easy to fix because we're going to lay this on nice sticky contact paper. This piece came out, and now we're left with the outline of our butterfly. So we'll move our scraps out of the way. And now it's time for a piece of contact paper. So take one of your pieces of contact paper, a little bit bigger than the butterfly. Now, easy way to get contact paper started is to grab the corner right here and make a little tear. It'll only tear the paper. It won't tear the sticky part. Then you have something to get a hold of to get it started. You want to lay the contact paper sticky side up, of course. Butterfly, and he has to put his belly down. So if you see the little smile on this side, that means he goes face down onto the contact paper. And then run your finger along the heart-shaped wings to make sure that he sticks. This is when our tissue paper comes into play. This is how we're going to make our beautiful butterfly. Now, I want to try to keep our tissue paper on the inside of the wing. Start placing it. Some of you might have learned in science class that the wings look the same on both sides. So if you want to, you can try to do that. But it's art, so you can make them look any way you want. I don't have any green in there yet. Let's put some green in there. Pieces, little pieces, any size you want pieces. And let's put some more yellow. I like yellow. It's a nice, bright, and happy color. So just keep going until you have the wings filled all the way in, any way that you would like to do it. And maybe I'll finish up here with some green. I believe I have all of my spots all filled in. Now what we do, I'm gonna clean up my tissue paper so I don't make a mess. All we have left to do is put one more piece of contact paper on the back and then a little bit of trimming. So we're going to open our second piece of contact paper, make a little tear by stretching it. Sometimes contact paper is stubborn. Kitty's not happy with the contact paper. Now we're going to take this piece and we're going to use it on the back of the butterfly. So we're going to lay it down gently. Roll it out. We're putting it together like almost like a sandwich. So we have one piece of contact paper, our butterfly, and another piece of contact paper, and it should look like this. The very last step is to take your scissors again, and we're going to cut around the outside, but we're going to leave just a little extra. Do you see the little bit of extra? That's so the contact paper will still stick together. Because it's clear, if you don't want to, you don't have to cut the antennas out again. You can just cut around them. Just remember to leave a little bit extra all the way around. When you're finished, you will have a beautiful butterfly. So, your hungry, hungry caterpillar has now turned into a beautiful butterfly. You think so, Charlie? He's still crying for bunnies over there. We might have to go outside. Bye.